Welcome to this session on deploying an application with dependencies. In this session, we're going to see how to deploy an application that has dependencies. We'll see that lifetime will still do its impact analysis. It will then try to understand the dependencies, suggest and resolve any dependency problems, and then actually do the deployment. So let's go ahead and look at this some more. If we're deploying an application with dependencies, then one of the applications is a consumer, and it's being deployed to another environment, since this consumer depends on the functionality of the other application, which is a producer. We need to make sure that the producer applications get deployed with the consumer applications, because if we get to the target environment and those producer applications are not there, we could end up with errors. Lifetime helps us avoid these types of situations by giving us a validate now step, where we'll be able to validate that the things we're moving from development will have the required dependencies in the next environment. So to do all of this, Lifetime does an impact analysis. It looks for any application dependencies that do not exist or are not up to date in the destination environment. And in this case, not up to date means not at the right version number. So for the deployment to proceed, all of these errors would need to be fixed. So if we look through an example, here we may go to our orders application and we ask it to deploy 0.1. When it goes to deploy 0.1 to quality, what it finds is that orders is based and is using the orders base application slash module as well. So because orders is using orders base, and orders base was set to do nothing, both of these are highlighted in red as being incorrect for that particular deployment. So to understand the dependencies a little bit more, once Lifetime warns us of such a state where there will be broken references and the producer application is going to be needed, what we can do is we can open the deployment that was going to be occurring, and we'll be able to see what the error is. So in this case, it will show us that deploying order 0.1 results in broken references because it's not compatible with the Dublin template or the order base that's going to be in the new environment. So to understand this even better, if we click on the show details, when we click on the show details, it will show us all of the different modules that are being used inside of this deployment. And when we hover on the X, here it gives us even more details where the module orders requires the Dublin theme from the Dublin template. So we're going to be able to, we have to have the Dublin theme to be able to make this work. And we also have modules orders requiring order base from the order base application. And that's because of a number of different entities. And it even shows us the number of elements that we are reusing from these other applications. So to be able to solve this, all we have to do is go look for the versions of those applications. So it mentioned the Dublin template, and we can grab that. It mentioned order base, so we need that as well. And we need to change them from do nothing to actually deploying 0.1. And this way, all three of them will be deployed together, and this will give orders all of its dependencies and will fix all of the errors that it might have. Now, that's how we resolve dependencies when we're actually missing different types of references. We can also have a version of the application problem. So in this example, we're looking at to-do core. And here our to-do app is going to be using the to-do core, and they're both at version 1.0. So when we ask to-do to be deployed, we try to deploy 1.0. And it immediately says that it can't do that, and it can't do that because it needs to-do core. So when we add to-do core, it will go ahead and solve the problem because both will be able to be deployed at version 1.0. But unlike before, where when we deploy to-do, there was no before when we were deploying things, the dependency wasn't even there. Here, the to-do core dependency is there, but it's not the same version that it needs to be able to work properly. So in this case, we go from doing nothing to changing it over to deploying 1.0, and when both of them are set to deploy 1.0, then we can go ahead and validate that and be able to continue. So when we get to the deployment stage and we know that everything is valid, the deployment can be triggered. And deploying the apps is as simple as clicking the deployment now, like we've talked about before. So that's it for deploying an application with dependencies. We've shown how to solve many of the problems when we have that, and how lifetime can really help us find the right things to make all of the dependencies become available. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.